And uncontrolled substance movers and shakers. Now we got a little bit of a interview clip. Method Man, first one out of the gate, solo deal. Let's do it.
Do it.
When y'all started getting solo deals, did that cause any friction between y'all?
No. I was the first, well, not with me. I was the first one out the gate.
Right.
You know, I always felt like I would get nervous when a new solo album dropped because I just wanted us to keep doing good. So we're building an empire and I saw how far we could take that shit. Plus, you know, it made me look better. I'm front
right.
man. Front man. Look at my dudes. They getting busy. They getting money.
But you was kind of front man in the group, like Method Man was a single.
I was the only one that wasn't really afraid of leaving it all out there on the stage and shit, whether that was a good or a bad thing, I don't know.
Yeah, I experienced that, seeing him live.
Yeah, and people took to it, you know?
Yeah.
So it's at the Cool House back in Toronto. And I'm the guy who's supposed to bring, because they came from the border, I'm the guy who's supposed to bring Wu-Tang the weed, and I got backstage passes, so I'm pumped. And I'm outside the backstage lineup, and the fucking bouncer is just, like, not letting us in. I'm like, buddy, like, what the fuck? Like, I'm on the list. You know I'm on the list. Why aren't you letting us in? And I had no idea what was going on. Anyway, finally, we get in, and we go backstage. There's a whole bunch of cool people we were hanging out with. And I'm kind of like, where's Wu-Tang? Some guy comes over to me. He's like, are you Wilkshake? I'm like, yeah. He's like, you got the weed? I'm like, yeah, I got the weed. Here you go. He gives me some money. And then he disappears. And I never saw Wu-Tang the entire show. I went out, watched the show. I just went out in main population and watched the show because you could see the stage better. Never met them. Bought them weed, though. That's what I did for them. Got them weed in Canada. That was nice. And at that point, weed was not legal yet. It wasn't legal yet. So I was taking a risk by doing that. But I got free tickets, and that was cool. And Method Man, speaking of that, seeing him on that stage, he is the front man, dude. Like, he had all these joints rolled up. He had, like, 20 joints rolled up. I'm like, I bought that weed! You know, he's like, passing out joints to everybody on stage. Everybody's smoking joints. And it was classic. And you saw that, like, showmanship, the leadership that he has on stage, the leaving it all out there on the stage, as he says.
Mm-hmm.
So this is now Method Man from his solo album, Tical or Tycho?
Tical. Yeah.
Tical.
Tical. Let's do it.
I actually haven't heard this in so long.
A lot of this stuff I haven't heard in so long.
Yeah, in a long time.
This is nice, man. This is a great idea.
Yeah. We're going to listen to everything. Everything.
You've been lucky.
No, but what's cool about it, though, is, like, you're not having to go through, like, the whole album to find the gems.
Right.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, now listen to the, that's it. Yeah, listen to the whole album, splitting it up.
One, two, 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 one, two,
I like this Paul sample guy.
What's that shit? Pass it over here. I got styles, all of them sick. Niggas ain't fit to walk a mile in the dead man's kit. I make them shit about the pack. I'll break the shut. He ain't nothing but the number. Unknown John Doe that wanna flow.
Here
coming up shit's creep. I come to throw monkey bitches in your program sleep. And I'ma grow like a rash on your nasty gas. And a whip with no brakes. And I'm hitting the gas. It's a bird, it's a plane. Take a look in the sky. Method Man on some shit. Niggas call me the fly. Cause my style is back to hopping turnstiles. Pay your fear. If you're greedy in the chair, you can bet out. Get severe on the double, I arrest it. I don't look for trouble, I'm already trouble. Your bastards at the wicked flow that I crafted. I'm another deadly venom style to be mastered by a psychopathic. Way beyond an average. Joe, where the hell if I flow? There you have it. What's the shit? Think it's strong. Chow, chow. Pass it over here now. Chow, chow, chow. What's the shit? Think it's smoking. Yeah. out the child. Pass it over here. One, two, 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 check it out. What goes off, what goes on, the method that we got is to stay hot, no question. Lethal weapon, ain't no time for half stepping. When brothers start wetting everything in your section, move that. Niggas came strapped, should've knew that. Do that, pussycat rap, boy, I'll screw that. Toe up, from the flow up, don't even show up to the battle, I heard you rattle. Now hold up, is there a fucking snake in my garden? Starving for a rap treat, stepping on my feet, parting your death before you find your death. In a fucked up situation without no help, I'm not playing, cause I don't play with nobody. Goddamn kid, know what I'm saying. I'm peeling niggas' wigs, I be spraying brothers with words, cause I gotta spit prime.
So smooth, man. Even back then, is this post 36 cases?
Cow, cow, what's that shit? Smoke. Cow, cow,
cow. What?
Is this pre or post 36
games? Post. Like right after.
What up, Forces?
Forces! Catching the end of the show, I like.
Where were you for the improvement of Ray and Ghost?
I'm curious, because he mentioned the chef in the start of that song. Is Raekwon a chef? Like, is he a cook? Did he grow up cooking? Or before Wu-Tang came big, was he a cook?
That's a good question.
Because they always call him the chef. And I wonder if he actually is. Because, you know, I went to chef school, and I'm sure that me and Raekwon could have some good conversations.
My understanding is he may have been a hood chef.
Okay.
Which,
like cooking meth?
Well, not necessarily meth, but he was,
crack.
He was cooking something.
Oh, that's serious. That's serious stuff that I don't even need to know about. I don't even need to know about that.
It could be kung fu shit too. A lot of their stuff is like,
again, you know what I mean? Like, again, you know, you hear a bunch of stuff, but you listen to his bars, and what I've gathered throughout the years and listening to Raekwon, when he refers when he's referred to as the chef, it's because back in the day he was involved in He was cooking. He was cooking in the hood. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Wow. Is that Staten Island? That's interesting. I never knew that. That's the kind of stuff that you don't learn unless you really pay attention, which I haven't. Great. Okay. I love it. Method Man, smooth. First track. You could tell this is like a bit of a build up. I'm sure the next song hits a little harder, and he's got that more of that snap in his voice. He was laid back, getting started, just warming up, you know. Tical. What do you say?
Tical.
What does it mean? Is it a mixture of two words? Weed. Tical means weed.
I think so.
Tical means, man, I learn a lot on these shows, man. I learn a fucking ton. Yeah, I'm gonna give that a solid 8. What do you say, Ignacio?
Oh, that's an 8.5. I mean, it's got a good groove to the beat. Method Man is just bouncing on, just in and out of different pockets on the beat. It's dope. It's dope. I'm gonna go with 8.5.
8.5, Preston. What are you saying?
Yeah, 8.25 for me. I really like the uncomfortableness of the bass.
Right.
I feel like
it was eerie almost. Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like Method Man's earlier stuff has kind of got like a little bit of a horrorcore vibe to it. You know what I mean?
Ooh. Yeah.
Yeah. 8.25. I loved it. I love the track. It's great. 8.25. Great way to start an album. And
mentioning horrorcore, everybody who's watching now, we got it. We're sold out for the next 3 weeks, I think, on the podcast.
It's crazy.
Yeah, basically.
So 6.1 sold out, then 6.2 is a horrorcore show. It is sold out. Then 6.3 is sold out. We're working on 6.4. So
we're working on 7.1, actually.
7.1, right. 6.4 will be a championship playlist. 7.1 we're working on. But yeah, the next that we got is a little video of them talking about Raekwon wrote every day.